As I mentioned at the beginning of our weathercast, there were some signs of rotation on that, and it looks like the National Weather Service has decided that was sufficient to produce that tornado warning. Something that we're going to be looking for here is where we have the reds and the greens next to each other, and that's where we have that rotation, and we'll actually pinpoint exactly where some of that is happening. Again, northeast of Kinross, north of Wellman. So as we back out the view just real quick here, so north of Highway 22 is where that is located. So if you recognize some of these locations, 325th Street, 320th Street, this is to the west of Frytown, by the way, the English River Wildlife Area, Lance Wildlife Reserve, that's where that possible tornado would be located at this time. Again, this storm is moving generally to the east, northeast at about 20 miles per hour. So I'll put a loop on this over the past 30 minutes to give you a sense of its motion. This is located really in far southeastern Iowa County, so in Williamsburg, you're not seeing this threat at all. It is off to your south and east. This is moving into southern Johnson County over the next little while. So I'll pause here and put a storm track on this with that storm moving in that direction. So bear with me while I put a track on here. Again, just north of east at about 25 miles per hour. So that would put it in the following areas over the next roughly hour. Next few minutes at the Lance Wildlife Reserve, Amish at 637, Windham at 645, Redbird Farms Wildlife Area at 651, Sharon Center at 654, Coleridge Mall at 709, the Iowa City Airport at 711, and downtown Iowa City at 714. Now, 7 o'clock is when that tornado warning is set to expire. However, we do, of course, watch that even beyond that expiration time. I do want to mention some of our severe weather safety as we go through here. So let me bring up some of that information for you, for those of you who are in that tornado warning. Obviously, we want you to go to your basement if you have one. Otherwise, if you don't have a basement, go to the lowest floor. One of our pieces of advice, this may seem a little odd at first, but put on shoes, because if there were to be a tornado and if your home got hit, there may be broken glass or things like that that you'd step on. So put on shoes before you go there. Go to the lowest floor, as I mentioned, like a basement. Get underneath something sturdy, a workbench, staircase, anything like that. If you have the option to put over a helmet, pillows, blankets over your head, that would be a good idea as well. In addition, some other pieces of advice for those of you under that tornado warning: we want to stay away from windows and doors. Put as many walls between you and the storm. So an interior room, such as a closet, a hallway, or a bathroom are good options in those particular cases. Again, that tornado warning does continue until 7 o'clock for the far northeastern corner of Keokuk County, although I would say the threat for you is pretty much past at this time. Southwestern Johnson County, far northern Washington County, generally north of Highway 22, and then southeastern Iowa County, as that storm is a portion of the storm is right about there at this time. Again, we'll come in a little bit closer here so you can see exactly where that warning box is located. Again, far southeastern Iowa County. This is does not include Williamsburg. Again, if you're in Williamsburg, this storm does not affect you at this time. This storm is located just northeast of Kinross and is going to be eventually making its way toward the Highway 1 corridor. It's not there just yet, but we are seeing at least some of that rotation happening in the far southeastern corner of Iowa County. So we'll bring on some of the streets here once again to give you a sense of where this is exactly located. We've got Johnson, Iowa Road. It's approaching that area here in the next few minutes. 320th Street in southeastern parts of Iowa County. Northwest of the town of Amish, Frytown is over in that area as well. Southwest of Windham. Let's see here. We'll get a few more of these to show up here. So 305th Street, 300th Street. Let's see, Blackhawk Avenue. Let's see, we've got WW Avenue, Y Avenue on some of those areas in southeastern portions of Iowa County, just as you get approaching the Johnson County area. So that's kind of what we're looking at this particular time. By the way, if somebody in the newsroom is able to try to find out if they're seeing any information from emergency management, that would be appreciated as well. I do know that trained weather spotters have been paged in those particular areas, so they'll be watching that storm as well. In addition, a new tornado watch is going to be coming out until midnight. Don't have the details on who is in that, but it's not overly surprising considering the fact that we do now have that tornado warning in effect for some portions of eastern Iowa. We'll bring on what that information is here again, and I'll zoom out so you can see a better view of exactly who is included in that. So southeastern Iowa County is in this. In fact, you're under the threat right now. southwestern Johnson County. That's where the storm is going to be moving into. If you live in far northeastern Keokuk County near Kinross, that storm is to your east at this time. In fact, that portion of the warning just got canceled. So again, northeastern Keokuk County, you are no longer in that tornado warning. Far northern portions of Washington County, generally along and north of Highway 22. That is where that tornado warning is located. Iowa City, you're right on the edge of it, so you're probably hearing in Johnson County the outdoor warning sirens going off. Seeing some reports of still a wall cloud rotating within this thunderstorm, but no tornado at this particular time. However, it is in an environment that would be favorable to produce a tornado. It is showing some signs of rotation, and it could touch down at any particular time. All right. A rundown of that tornado watch includes Cedar, Clinton, Dubuque, Henry, Iowa, Jackson, Jefferson, Johnson, Jones, Keokuk, Lynn, that includes Cedar Rapids, and Washington counties. That goes until midnight tonight. So a good share of eastern Iowa. I'll have a map here of that coming up shortly once all that information does come in. In fact, I may be able to bring that up right now with this new tornado watch that goes until midnight. So those are the counties in yellow. I haven't updated the text on that. It goes until midnight, not 11 p.m., but those yellow blinking counties generally along and south of Highway 151 have that tornado watch that goes until midnight. Any storms that do develop this evening through that time will be capable of producing a tornado. We've already seen some of that potential occur in southeastern portions of Iowa County. Now, for those of you who live in the Iowa City metro, let's say Iowa City, North Liberty, Coralville, that particular area, if you live in a mobile home, I want you to be considering where you can go because a mobile home does not offer substantial protection from a tornado. Again, there's no tornado occurring at this time, but if this storm does maintain its intensity that far northeast, you want to be in a different place. In fact, it may not be a bad idea to go to a more a better shelter at this particular time because it does take some time to get there. Those of you in southwestern Johnson County around the Frytown area, Amish, Winden, Sharon Center, you need to be in your tornado safe place as well.